name is Melissa Miller, and I work at Scripps Institution of Oceanography. I'm out on the research vessel Roger Revelle in the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii, and I'm here to answer a question from Mrs. Connolly's first grade class, Cohort A, which is how deep is the deepest part of the ocean? The deepest part of the ocean is the Mariana Trench, and that's in the Western Pacific Ocean near Japan and the Philippines. It's over 36,000 feet deep, which is almost 7 miles from the surface of the ocean to the bottom of the seafloor. I've actually analyzed some samples that came back from there that were collected by James Cameron on his Deep Sea Challenger submersible. The rest of the ocean is mostly much more shallow than that, an average of 12,000 feet or a little over 2 miles deep, which is still pretty deep when you think about it. Where I am right now, we use this multi-beam system to tell us the depth of the ocean and the sub-bottom profiler as well. And they both read out in meters of about 4,000 meters, which is about 14,000 feet or 2.5 miles from where we are in the boat to the seafloor. As we travel along, this multi-beam system that's mounted below the ship sends out a sound pulse that reflects back, and that tells us how far away the ocean floor is, and it maps a swath of the ocean as we go by. Where we are right now off of Hawaii isn't super interesting, but there's some really cool features sometimes we go over, like mountain ridges and also volcanoes. So those are always really cool to see. And that data ends up in Google Earth and other open data sets so that you can just go and look around and see all the cool features on the seafloor. There's still so much left to explore.
Hello, my name is Hitomi Taguchi and I'm a PhD in chemical engineering. Today we have a question from Vasni from Albert Einstein Academy. So Vasni's question is, how do people figure out what chemicals or ingredients to use to do stuff? Interesting question, Vasni. It's very much like cooking. So when chefs cook meals, they first have an idea of what that meal is going to be like. It might be tacos, it might be sushi, but they know what that final meal is going to look like, taste like, crunch like. Then, once they have that vision, they go out into the market and start buying the veggies, or the meat, or the spices that they need to make that meal. When they choose that ingredients, they base it on their flavor, they base it maybe on the color, they might base it, of course, on how it tastes to your tongue, how it might mix together, all these things. It's based on their knowledge. It's based on their experience about these ingredients, veggies, meat, and spices. It's also based on their knowledge and experience of the cooking techniques. How will you cut them? How are you going to heat them? Or do you want to serve it cold? All of these combined together, they come up with the procedures and the ingredients needed to make that meal. When people are trying to come up with chemicals and ingredients to do what they're trying to do, it's very similar. They have the final product. It might be a completely new molecule. It might be a new device, but they have that final project in mind. They know what they want to achieve. They know what it's going to look like or feel like or react like. And based on that final vision, they go out into their previous experiences, maybe their knowledge, maybe their colleagues, and they start gathering information and data about the different chemicals and ingredients that they can use to make that final product. Now, just like cooking, especially the first-time cookers, oftentimes it's not gonna go well the first time. So people are going to experiment. They're going to first try it out with the first combination of chemicals and ingredients. They do it this and that, they mix it up or they shake it up. And after that, they see if that really, their hypothesis of whether all these ingredients and chemicals are going to work, whether it works or not, they test it out. And then they look, compare it with their ideal vision. If it's not quite right, they go back to the drawing board and they try a different chemical and they try a different ingredient. They mix it up and do whatever they need to do. And then they analyze the final product and then check. Did it become better? Did it go worse? How closer is it to their final vision? And then they go back again to the drawing board. So how people figure out what chemicals or ingredients to use is actually, in many cases, by trial and error and persistence and optimism. Very, very rare that they know from the very beginning what chemical and ingredients they need to do their stuff. So, Farsi, great question. I hope this answer was helpful and keep on asking great questions. Thank you.